Hello there. I hear it's gonna rain.
Yeah.
That's what they're saying.
Yeah. You're from Chicago, you should be used to that.
You should be.
So it always changes.
Good thing I didn't wash my hair. Would have been all in vain.
It looks good.
Thank you. It's a lot of product. A lot going on in the roots there. All right. You're too far away from me tonight, and I can't differentiate wrong from right. I hear there's a moon up in the sky, but I see you in every light. I should have turned and walked away, live to survive another day. Doing some of these shows together. It's been really fun to play and get to know each other, and Shelley and Eric are lovely, delightful people, and it's been fun to meet her fans, and I'm honored to get to play in front of some of you tonight, and I know I've got some college friends here tonight. Yes? Maybe? High school? Do I have college? Do we have college?
Maybe?
Oh, okay. I recognize that voice. She's normally not shy.
All right.
I went to Lawrence University in Appleton, so I'm kind of an honorary Scotty. And my parents live in Wisconsin. So,
yay!
What am I playing?
I'm close to being in tune here. Let's see.
Somewhere over there. Should I get it or should I just play the song without the harmonica? Oh, okay.
All right. You're in for it.
My mentor, John Gorka, always said, you don't want to do too smooth of a show because it makes people suspicious. So I'm going to go do that. I feel like now I'm accomplishing the not-so-smooth show. Half-year-old son, and then just turned 7-year-old boy-girl twins.
Wow.
I know, and apparently they're all going to need orthodonture, says the dentist. So this is what that made me think of that. Although you don't have to wear these anymore, right? You don't have to wear like the big
Invisalign.
John Cusack in 16 Candles, like the bib for the water fountain. So they're not going to have to do that, but my one son does have a little bit of a jaw issue, so we'll see. It's all right, I mean, it's only being taped, he's just going to be in therapy later. What did you say on stage, Mom? It's fine. All right, so I wrote this song in the last century. with Kristen Hall and Emily Salyer, so the Indigo Girls, and two very incredibly talented writers, songwriters, singer-songwriters, and we were talking about the government and like what we were mad at and whatever, talking about the world, and ultimately came to the conclusion that the only thing we had control over was ourselves, because it's good to be, you know, upset and noticed, but how are we making a difference? And, locally or in our own lives. And so this is a song called I'll Start With Me, which, even though it was written in the last century, could have been written last week.
Yeah. All right.
Well, we do okay with the things God gave us. Will it be enough when it's time to save us? One in three can't read. So many mouths to feed. We just sit and wait like a loaded gun. We cloak ourselves in the great tradition, the United States of acquisition. Every man for himself, it's just me and no one else. Will we ever learn there's a price to pay? Their color. That's why in times of peace, we create an enemy. What we call the big red scare is just my neighbor over there with hopes and dreams. The same as me, the same as me. Day. It's sometimes abridged now because he likes to read in bed, and it's very effective for helping him fall asleep. I don't know. You know, when they're babies, they're captive audience, so you know, you sing to them and there's nothing they can do about it. But at some point when he started to talk, he decided to individuate a little bit, and he's like, no, Mom, no singing. Yeah. Read books. Yeah. I'm good with the books. Yeah. I'm like, okay, you don't want me to sing? So I wrote this song. I did a song a week challenge several years ago with 20 other female singer-songwriters around the country. And we were given a word prompt, and then we had to write a song, kind of jump off from that. I'm proud to say I wrote 52 songs, which was, wow. You know, yeah, I was positive that wasn't going to be possible when they asked me to do it, because I had, you know, the twins were 3 or 4, I don't know, they were little, and there's no way I can write a song a week. But I learned a few things from it, and one of them was that the well is never dry. There's always a song to be written, and I had to learn to be really efficient with my time and be like, okay, they're napping, I've got 2 hours. So I'm not saying they were always good songs, but they were songs, and I did it. And then the second thing I learned is that I'm very motivated by public shame, because we would share the songs on YouTube and Facebook, and be damned if I wasn't going to finish my song. So anyway, this was our prompt word was vulnerable, and I thought, boy, I've never felt more vulnerable than. When I became a parent, because it's just like, sometimes people describe it as having your heart outside your body, and I think that's true. So this is a song called Free and Wild. It's on my new record, which I have here tonight with me.
Oh yeah.
Just in case anybody, it's officially being released September 20th, but you special folks here at Shank, Milwaukee. That one, yes, ma'am. That one, yes, right there.
Minnesota.
That's what it's called. Must be said with that accent. Anyway, so this is Free and Wild.
Go to sleep, my baby child. Let your dreams run free and wild. I'll be there when you wake up, so close your eyes, my baby love. And I will catch you when you fall, 'cause your mama loves you most of all. The love so fierce, it almost hurts me. Here come the tears, and now I can't breathe. But I'm lucky to love, lucky to feel, lucky to have someone in my life who shows me what's real. what's true. All the things that I'm learning, loving you. Your mind is such a magic place. You're filled with vision, blessed with grace. I love it when you sing along to your favorite TV song, but you don't like it when I sing. You say, Mama, you're good at other things. Like reading books and doing all the voices. And when you put your cold feet on me, I've no choice but to say I'm lucky to love, lucky to feel, lucky to have someone in my life who shows me what's real and what's true. All the things that I'm learning, loving you. Someday I'll have to let you go. Someday I'll have to trust that you can do it on your own. But until then, I'll hold your hand. Someday you will understand. When you have a child yourself, you'll think of how your mother felt and how I can't imagine my life before you came and brought your light, and how your little smile just slays me. How loving you saved me. I'm lucky to love, lucky to feel, lucky to have someone in my life who shows me what's real and what's true. All the things that I'm learning, loving you. Yeah, the things I'm learning, loving you. So go to sleep, my baby child. Let your dreams run free.
Bathroom, and there they are, you know, when they were little, they'd be like, hands under the door, Mom, Mom, are you in there? Mom just needs a minute, please. And I just came back from a pretty epic canoe trip up in the Quatico Provincial Park in Canada, just north of Minnesota's boundary waters, but in Canada, and with eight other very strong-spirited women, and it was great. You know, we portage, you know, I solo loaded my canoe and carried it on the portages, which made me feel super, super tough. And then, you know, we carried Wanigan's old school wooden Wanigan's, like boxes with our kitchen stuff in it and, you know, things like that, and then big Duluth packs and things. So it was very challenging, and the weather was sunny, and then it became fall about halfway through our trip. Which it does up there, it just turns fast. But the issue I want to address right now is pooping. Because, I'm sorry, everybody poops. I could just call it number two. I'll just call it that. That's more polite. And when you're in the wilderness, you know, you have to go in the woods. And you gotta dig a hole. And then cover up your tracks. And then we put two sticks so that, you know, whoever might come across it in the future, just don't dig your hole there. But anyway, so, you know, with eight, nine women, there was a lot of discussion of, you know, how, have you gone yet? And because that's what women talk about. I don't know that the guys talk about things like that. You probably keep it to yourself. But maybe you do. I mean, it's a canoe trip. It's pretty intimate, you know. We're hauling stuff together. And so maybe by end of day two, might have been into day three, you know, and I have my friend Kathy just like holds it in. She's like, I just don't go for 7 days. My body just shuts down. She's like, I know. So what do you do? But I was like day three. I was like, okay, it's time. I'm gonna go try. I'm going into the woods, and then I don't know, the red squirrels that yell at you, and it's upsetting sometimes because you're like, why are you yelling at me? I'm trying to have a moment here. Mommy needs a minute. And I thought it might be helpful if some of the ladies could just yell mom from the campsite. And I mentioned that, and my friend Barb, so I'm in the woods and she's like, mom, where are my shoes? And it worked. So, sorry fellas. This is the title track, though, for my new album, Minnesota. And I have the blessing of being able to spend my summers up in two wilderness camps right on the Minnesota-Canadian border. And I did grow up in Minnesota. And so it's nice to be able to experience that again and to watch my kids, you know, being super free range in the summer and catching frogs and doing stuff. So this is kind of a love song to my childhood home. The moon is waxing over the water, a silver path across the lake. The moon is calling to her lover, the sweetest love song ever sang. In a soda land of my childhood, you are flowing through my veins, and I am drawn to your safe harbor, forever thirsty for a drink. Last night we watched the electric light show playing wide across the sky. Sat on the front porch, your safe harbor, forever thirsty for a drink. Like a willow, my roots grow stronger, searching deep, searching wide. I wanna linger a little longer till I reach the other side. The moon is waxing over the water, a million stars fill up the night. I am nothing, I am holy, a voyager under northern lights. Minnesota, land of my childhood, you
forever thirsty for day.
So this next song was inspired by the gentleman that took the photographs for my Who I Am record, wonderful rock photographer named Henry Diltz. And Henry has a million stories to share. He took some of the most iconic album cover photos in the 70s singer-songwriter genre. Oof. I've always wanted to use that word on stage. The oof. Isn't that someone's work? Like the oof. O-U-R-V-E. Never mind. Anyway, Henry, he took the Doors Morrison Hotel album cover and the Eagles Desperado, and he was like, yeah, we went out to Joshua Tree, we took some peyote, and, so he's got great stories, and he hung out in Joni Mitchell's kitchen, and, cool stuff. Yeah. Anyway, he went down the wrong way. Oh, dear. I've been kombuched. Smooth show. Just reminding you all. And we were just talking about life, training stories. Oh, that's a problem. And he said, Alice, I find it really helpful when someone has wronged me to be able to say thank you. You're my teacher. And I thought, well, that's just great because maybe you can't say it in your outside voice. Maybe it's just in here, but I feel like, then nothing's a mistake. It's all a good learning experience, and you take something away from it. So it's never a waste of your time, right? You can't just be like, oh, my 20s were wasted. They were not. I mean, in my case, for instance, I can't say that. No. So this is called Taught Me Well. Hate to be ignored, or maybe you're just bored. So I open up my mail and there's a note from you. You say you're checking in just to see how I've been. Hey, I'm doing so much better. If you'd like to know the truth, you taught me well. You were my teacher and I thank you for the help. Quite clear, only I was suffering here, and having gratitude for you was the way out of this. You taught me well, you were my teacher, and I thank you for the help you put me through. I'm very grateful, cause I finally really learned what was important in my life, and I thank my lucky stars every day. I'm not sure why. You taught me through. I'm very grateful, cause I finally really Thank you. Dissolves the dust. What remains of the two of us? 'Cause you have left an empty space, a memory that's hard to trace. A momentary flash of light in time. He's a wonderful, wonderful Grammy award-winning songwriter, Tony-nominated playwriter. He and his brother did Something Rotten on Broadway. He's a multi-talented man, and a dear, dear, kind, loving, wonderful person. And there's a song called Dry Spell. And it's interesting, we wrote this at a time, so I made this new record, and the twins started full-day kindergarten last year, so I was like, all right, I have a little time, you know, for from 8:30 to 3:30.
But I thought I could go in and get into the studio, and so this is one of the songs I recorded.
I think Dry Spell. There was a time there where I thought, I don't know, am I going to create again? And who am I? I mean, being a mom is amazing. It's the best thing I've ever done, for sure. But it's a mind bender sometimes.
And I think it's kind of that fallow time where you're, it's fun. I read this book that I love called Wolfpack by Abby Wambach. And one of her tenets, along with, you know, supporting other women, and, you know, it's not a pie. It's not like if she gets something, it takes something away from me. And, you know, so she has all these sort of sports rules to live by. And, you know, supporting other women, you know, demand the ball. And one of them is lead from the bench. And, you know, sometimes life, it feels sort of like you get benched. You know, you're not on the starting team. And motherhood, early motherhood, sort of felt like that to me for a minute. I was like, wow, okay, so now what? I mean, this is amazing, but I can't even put a sentence together. Or take a shower.
Right.
Or go to the bathroom by myself, right? So, all right. Anyway, so this is called Dry Spell, and let's see. Yeah, that's it.
Guess it was just an illusion. I thought that I'd have it all worked out, and I'd have it down by now. Well, gray skies are so hungry that day. Sometimes I just wanna disappear. But where do I go from here? Feel the weight of the world on my shoulders. Am I wiser or am I just older? Waiting for water, I drift through this dry spell. Quietly in desperation, wondering what all is yet to be. What is left of me? So many cracks in the pavement, so many things that have fallen through, searching for something. Just older, waiting for water, I drift through this dry spell. Thank you. water, I drift through the dry spell. Waiting for water, I drift through this dry spell.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Did you see more for me? Let's take a break. And Shelly's going to come out with Eric Hobbick, her guitarist. They're going to put on a show for you, I promise. I'd like to thank Robert for the lovely sound. Thank you, Robert. He's a professional. He knows what he's doing. It's much appreciated. And everybody here at Shank Hall for taking good care of us. Thanks, Dave. All right, let's see here. Mm-hmm. So I used to live in Chicago for many years, and this song was written about, there was a fire in my neighborhood, and a homeless woman had set fire in the stairwell of a three flat, and she told the police later she'd been trying to warm her feet, and four young people died in the fire, and it was awful. And I was reading about the story later in the paper, and she'd grown up on the South Side. And people who knew her as a little girl or a young woman growing up talked about how beautiful she was and outgoing and vivacious, and then something changed, and just the story was just so tragic all the way around. So I wrote this with my friend Greg Becker down in Nashville, and it's called I Am Mary. I am Mary, I was pretty. You may remember me from the ninth grade. The boys would hold me, and my friends told me the world would know me someday. Well, I made choices and heard some voices, fought the battles inside my head. Life's a fabric, but when I grabbed it, all I got was a handful of threads. There's a stairwell that I know so well, 'cause it gets cold out on the street. A crumpled dollar to start a fire so that I could warm my feet. And police stations, investigations of a fire burning bright. Show me pictures of those children, and told me I was there that night. Ooh. Ooh. And medication, all my friends have left me now. No one could see them, but now I need them to help me figure all this out. Why do they feed me, give me TV and a blanket for my feet? But something's working, 'cause it starts hurting when it all comes back to me.
I am Mary. I was ready. You may remember me from the ninth grade. The boys would hold me, and my friends told me the world would know me someday.
School music meeting tonight, and also curriculum night. Last year he signed me up for crafts for all of the parties in the classroom. That was his revenge. I'm the least Pinterest person you know. I was like, are you kidding me, crafts? So probably I'm gonna come home and I'll be the room mom, I don't know. Yeah. Audience, thank you.
Please feel free to tune amongst yourselves.
I'm about to play Hard Day's Night. I am not. I'm not sure what chord that is. Let me just check.
Wow.
I mean, I am feeling a little gassy tonight.
I don't know if that's why.
That's what men talk about.
What? That's what men talk about? Oh, see, I'm off by it. A note here. Yeah, that helps. There we go. Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, good.
That'd be much more pleasant for your ears. Your touch is
there's only one. you wait for me on heaven's shore. May the sting of death don't work no more. Hallelujah to the Lord above. Hallelujah for the Savior's love. Hallelujah, what will I sing? Hallelujah, even in all things. The river's wide and the road is hard. You brought these tears and broke my heart. All they've left for me is just one choice, to bow my head and lift my voice. Hallelujah to the Lord above. Hallelujah for the Savior's love. Hallelujah, will I sing? Hallelujah, even in all things. All things.